Hello and welcome to the second video for the first part of Inequalities. In the previous video, I talked about the ideas and concepts. Here we're going to do a bunch of examples. And I'll start with two examples that illustrate the idea of preserving or reversing. These are the two things that I mostly talked about, is that some operations will preserve inequalities and some operations will reverse inequalities. So let's start with this first example. What numbers, when I multiply by 4 and subtract 7, are less than 12? So I can add 7 to both sides of this equation, or rather both sides of this inequality. Adding or subtracting any number preserves inequalities, so that's a valid thing that I can do. So if I add 7, I get 4x on the left, I get 19 on the right. And here then I can divide both sides of the equation by 4. Dividing or multiplying by a positive number preserves inequalities, so this is a valid thing to do. I can do it to both sides, the inequality remains. The 4 cancels off on the left, and I end up with x less than 19 quarters. That is my answer, and I said in the previous video to expect ranges for answers. This is a range. This is a whole section of the number line, all numbers less than 19 over 4, so some small positive numbers and all possible negative numbers satisfy this. And I expected that. I expect a range. Let's look at the second example. Here I'm going to subtract 15 from both sides of the equation. So the 15 minus 15 on the left goes away. 50 minus 15 is 35. So I'm left with negative 6x greater or equal 35. And then I'm going to divide by negative 6. Dividing by a negative number switches the inequality. So the direction here switches when I move down there. This greater than now becomes a less than. So anytime I multiply or divide by a negative number, I switch the direction of my inequality. The negative 6 goes away in the left. I get negative 35 over 6. A negative in the numerator or denominator of a fraction is just the same thing as the negative of the fraction. So I get all numbers that are less than or equal to negative 35 6 is the range that satisfies the original inequality. So those are the basic ideas of preserving and reversing inequality worked out in an example. We'll do some more examples in this video to try and get more familiar and deal with some of the subtleties that come up. So here's an example. What numbers, when I multiply by 9 and subtract 4, are less than the same number multiplied by 7 and add 5. Notice the variable happens on both sides here. That's fine. I can add 4 to both sides. Adding or subtracting any number preserves the inequality. So minus 4 plus 4 goes away. 5 plus 4 is 9. Then I have variables on both sides. So what I'm going to do in the second step is I'm going to subtract negative 17x from both sides. So I can still work with a variable. Now, I don't know whether x is positive or negative, but it doesn't matter for addition and subtraction. Addition and subtraction by any numbers still preserves the inequality. So this is a thing I can do, and the inequality won't change. 17x minus 17x goes away on the right. 9 minus 17 is negative 8. So I end up with the inequality negative 8x less than 9. And now I'm going to divide by negative 8. That cancels the negative 8 off the left side. I get negative 9 eighths on the right. And I've divided by a negative number, so the direction of the inequality is switched. So the solution to the original inequality in its complicated form is all numbers that are strictly larger than negative 9 eighths. Here's an example involving something that I want to use an exponent on. So I have the square root of 6x minus 4 is greater or equal 17. Which numbers satisfy this? I also have to be careful here, since not all numbers can even be put into the square root. In order for the square root to make sense, I need the thing inside the square root to be larger or equal 0, because I can't take the square root of a negative number. So that's a thing I have to remember, that some of these operations might not even work for the range that shows up. I'll have to compare the range I get at the end to this initial assumption that goes into this question. So working under that initial assumption, I want to square both sides of this. Now my rule from the previous video says I'm allowed to apply positive exponents, positive whole exponents like squares, as long as both sides are positive. 17 is positive, and by definition, the square root is positive. So that's fine. So my condition is satisfied. I am allowed to apply this square, this positive whole exponent, because both sides of the inequality are positive. On the left, square root and square cancel each other off. If I square root something, then square it, I get the original, as long as the original is positive. But my assumption said that the original had to be positive, so that works. 17 squared is 289. And then I can keep going. I can add 4 to both sides. That preserves inequalities, cancels the 4 off the left. 289 plus 4 is 293. I can divide by 6 on both sides. Cancels the 6 on the left. Dividing by a positive number preserves the inequality. I get 293 over 6. That should be a 6 in the denominator. And that gives me the range of numbers that satisfy the original equality. Now, I have to think about my assumption, but numbers that are larger equal 293 over 6, those are reasonably large numbers, nearly 30 and larger. So if I multiply by 6 and subtract 4, all of those numbers are going to satisfy my original assumption without any problem. So I conclude that my range of greater or equal 293 over 6 is in fact the range that satisfies this inequality. Couple more examples dealing with some subtleties that come up. Here I have x squared plus 6 larger than 3. Well, I can subtract 6 from both sides. That preserves the inequality. I get x squared larger than negative 3. And here I can say, wait a second. All square numbers are positive, and all positive numbers are larger than any negative number. So this is just simply true of all numbers. And we can do that. Sometimes we can look at an inequality and interpret it and say, oh, I know what's going on here. All square numbers are positive. All positive numbers are larger than negative 3. So I don't really have to do any more work. I know this is going to be true for all positive or for all numbers. So this is good to keep in mind that with interpretation and familiarity, we can reach some conclusions without necessarily having to do all of the algebraic manipulations. So this was less than 3. What if I had the same thing but less than 10? So again, I can subtract 6 from both sides. 6 cancels on the left, and I get 10 minus 6, which is 4 on the right. And here I have something where x squared larger equal 4 is actually a condition. It's going to be true for some numbers and not true for others. In the previous video, I talked about rules for square roots. I can take the square root of both sides, and that gives me this, x larger than negative 2. But I also have to consider possibly large negative numbers whose squares become large positive numbers. So I get this or this. So for things that where the square was larger than a certain value, I got two possible cases. So my initial inequality here is satisfied by all numbers that are larger equal 2 or less equal negative 2.